just received a telegram. Dear Tom Campbell off of Cultaholic, stop. Been watching your news videos and watching all the jokes at the beginning. Stop. Please stop.
I get it.
Wrestling news. Everything we know so far about WWE ThunderDome. A top WWE star says everything in WWE could be better. And two NXT stars get called up to Monday Night Raw. We'll talk about it in a bit. We don't need another hero. We don't need to find a way home. All we want is life beyond. The ThunderDome was trending last night. WWE making a big announcement about plans for their shows coming at the Amway Center. And it involves a revolutionary new way of putting on professional wrestling programming. Here is the press release from WWE. WWE ThunderDome featuring a state-of-the-art set, video boards, pyrotechnics, lasers, cutting-edge graphics, and drone cameras will take WWE fans viewing experience to an unprecedented level starting this Friday, August 21st on Fox, kicking off SummerSlam weekend. WWE has a long history of producing the greatest live spectacles in sports and entertainment. This is from the press release. Yet nothing compares to what we are creating with WWE ThunderDome, said Kevin Dunn, WWE's executive vice president of television production. The structure will enable us to deliver an immersive atmosphere and generate more excitement amongst the millions of fans watching our programming around the world. Now, Kevin Dunn makes a big statement about ThunderDome. We'll get to it in a little bit, but to finish off the press statement, with the debut of WWE ThunderDome, WWE will take residency at Amway Center in Orlando and virtually bring fans into the arena via live video on massive LED boards in conjunction with the famous group and its proprietary technology for every Monday Night Raw, Friday Night SmackDown, and WWE pay-per-view event. Starting tonight, i.e. last night, fans can register for their virtual seat to be part of upcoming shows via WWEThunderDome.com or at WWE's Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter pages. So, we are looking at a massive operation of like lights and pyro, and it's going to look big. Like, if any company's going to do this and do it well, it's going to be WWE. It's going to be massive. There's lots of elements to this. I think the one that has captured the imagination of quite a few fans is the fan cam bit. So you can go onto WWEThunderdome.com and you can register have your presence at a wrestling show, presumably via a webcam, staring down the ring. No doubt the fan cams are going to produce some memorable moments, including maybe some body parts, maybe a couple of AEW signs, probably this as well. I can imagine that there is somebody in WWE HQ who has already pre-written a press release apologising for the nudity. And I'm pretty sure BuzzFeed have already written an article that says, hashtag Spunky Cock Dance is trending online and we are living for it. So Kevin Dunn had a little bit more to say about the ThunderDome. He said, quote, we can now do things production-wise that we could never otherwise do. We're flying drones around the arena. We are putting a roof inside the Amway Center, and we're able to project content onto the roof. So when a big star like Drew McIntyre comes down to the ring, the whole arena will turn into his content. Lasers, pyro, smoke, projections on the top of the building and on the floor. It will be a big, beautiful entrance, better than WrestleMania. SmackDown is going to get entrances this Friday better than WrestleMania. Dunn said that and everything. Kevin Dunn said that. Really ambitious project by WWE. And a big part of this, this introduction of the ThunderDome, is part of the reason why they moved to the Amway Center. It's that idea that people have got a little bit tired of seeing wrestling from the Performance Center. So consequently, they need something that is going to shake things up and bring people back. And I think a spectacle like this, adding all that sizzle to the steak, is going to really help bring some new eyes onto the WWE product. So as also mentioned in that press release, WWE have confirmed their residency at the Amway Center, a residency that is costing them just under $500,000. This comes from Spectrum News 13. Jeff Allen reported that WWE are paying the Amway $450,000 to be there. I mean, when you break it down, they paid $2 million for WCW. So an empty arena is a quarter of the value of the entire World Championship Wrestling. But that was another story from from another time. Yesterday, there was a meeting of the Orange County Coronavirus Public Update, and WWE were present for it. The mayor of Orlando, Buddy Dyer, said that they will be airing live on Mondays and Fridays in Orlando until the end of October. There's cleaning and safety precautions that are in place. In general, the feeling is that Orlando are really happy to have WWE there, spending some money within the city and bringing some eyes upon the city as well. When asked whether or not that we could see fans in the Amway Center, or at least beyond the 60 days that planned, there was no answer officially given. But I would imagine that first chance we get to get fans in, they've got the Amway Center, they've got room for fans. I'm pretty sure they will bring them in first chance that they get. And if it gets to a point where we're still not quite ready to get anything back to a semblance of normal by the end of October, I can't see WWE going back to the Performance Center at this point. I feel like they will continue either at the Amway Center, or they'll just find somewhere else that they can go that's of a similar size. So lots of talk about the ThunderDome. We will see it for the very first time this Friday on SmackDown. Good idea to have this bad boy on SmackDown on Friday, as it's going to give us a chance to iron the bugs out of it, I think. Incidentally, when it comes to the name ThunderDome, the question is, who owns it? I was singing Tina Turner at the start, because the first thing I thought of when I saw ThunderDome was the Mad Max movie. Surely there's going to be some copyright issues there. Well, apparently not. According to the Trademark Office of America, there is something like 9 active trademarks for ThunderDome. The name ThunderDome is being used by a web development company, by a law firm, by a brewing company, and by a restaurant. Where should we go for our anniversary, darling? Or should we go to ThunderDome? That'll be lovely. So I don't think there's going to be any issue with WWE using ThunderDome. However, I'm curious as to whether it was going to be called something else, because I noticed in the URL that they had for ThunderDome when the announcement came down yesterday, that the URL actually said ThunderZone, as opposed to ThunderDome. Either this is WWE were going to go with a different name and then just went, screw it, we'll name it after the Mad Max movie, or maybe somebody in tech got it wrong. Just going to put that out there anyway. Maybe it was nearly called the ThunderZone. I don't know. But we'll find out what it's all about on Friday. So no sooner had ThunderDome been announced that we had photos from the Amway Center giving us a little indication of what this bad boy looks like, thanks to Roadie for Life on Instagram. An entire life spent as a roadie. Imagine such a thing. And as you can see there, a big old rig being set up, a big old wall of LED lights, and somewhere amongst all of this is all those teeny tiny little cameras that are going to be broadcasting lots of fans' faces to the wrestlers watching. I can imagine that's going to be weird, isn't it? Is that not going to be weird for a wrestler? See all those webcams staring at you? Very strange, very strange indeed. But there's our first little look at what it's going to be. At the moment, to look at these pictures, it just kind of looks like just your common old garden sort of scaffolding setup for a WWE show. But as we're finding out, it's going to be something quite grandiose. Few other bits of wrestling news before I let you go. Seth Rollins was having a chat with the Bleacher Report and was asked whether or not WWE could be doing anything better. And Seth's answer was pretty strong. He said, not just the company, but myself, the talent around me, everyone in the back, the writers, the consistency, the conversations, the communication, everything could be better right now. It's so hard to pick just one and say, ah, that's going to be the ticket. That's going to do it. It's a work in progress. And I think going out there and consistently doing your job is the best that you can. And helping other people out would be the best way to move this thing forward. So Seth Rollins kind of getting a little insight there into kind of what we've already talked about, which is there is some issues with communication and just some general morale issues. And I don't know how much somebody from the company going out and saying everything could be better is going to help things. I don't know. Seth has a habit of going to these media junkets and inserting his foot straight into his mouth and burning it down. I feel like he's done it again here. The Ring of Honor Pure Championship is coming back very soon, and we have details on how the tournament is going to break down. If you're a big fan of old school wrestling style, you're going to love the Pure Championship tournament. Every match beginning and end with a code of honor handshake. Each wrestler has 3 rope breaks that they can use during the match. Closed fist punches aren't permitted. You can use open hand slaps, though. Standard Ring of Honor matches, like with standard Ring of Honor matches, there's a 20 count when the wrestler's on the ground. If you interfere in a pure championship match, you are immediately sacked from Ring of Honor. Those are the rules laid out by Ring of Honor. 15-minute time limit in round one of the tournament, 20-minute time limits in the block semifinals, 30-minute time limit in the block final, and the tournament final will have an hour time limit. And there will be judges on hand in the event that the time limit runs out to decide who wins what. Pretty cool sounding tournament if you're an old school wrestling fan. Yesterday, as well as this, New Japan Pro Wrestling announced their King of Pro Wrestling tournament. And it's far wackier. Jack will be along later today with the more Cultaholic Wrestling news. He will tell you all about that. It's a thing of beauty. And finally, two NXT call-ups for Monday Night Raw last night. We welcome Marina Shafir and, let's see if over a year later I can get this right, Jessie Manduke. Close enough. The Horsewomen have arrived on Monday Night Raw and they made their presence felt on Raw Underground. Won't go into too many details on this right now. But it's great to see Duke, Shafir and Baszler united on Monday Night Raw. And as part of Raw Underground, we're still at this point where we're trying to figure out who Raw Underground is for. And I don't see any reason why we can't make this a device for the Horsewomen and have them run the show. That would be pretty cool. We're going to talk more about this in Raw Graded later on today on the Cultaholic YouTube channel, as we will grade everything that happened on Monday Night Raw last night. And I'm sure Ross has stuff to say about this as well when we get to the WTF moments of Monday Night Raw later today on the YouTube channel as well. But a good fit for Raw Underground. Big fan of these guys getting called up. It's very much in their wheelhouse. I'm excited to see more from them. And I'm excited to see more from the ThunderDome. Go to cultaholic.com. Whenever we find out stuff, we'll just hoy it straight over there for you. Stay safe. Love you. Bye.